Okay, I pressed record. Good morning.
Hi,
Jack. Hi, Caitlin.
Morning, Jack. Hi, Jackie.
This is Cady Jax Knits.
Yep, and I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Jackie, and it's episode 31.
Woo-hoo.
Welcome. What is it? It's Sunday, May 3rd? 3rd? I thought Friday was the first. It's very impressive to know the dates these days. It's May.
Is it? Okay.
It's May, you guys. And Caitlin, is that your Zoom background or is that real life?
No, this is real life. Coming to you from Knoxville, Tennessee. And I'm sitting on the front porch because it's the only place I can get decent light and potentially strong Wi-Fi. So let's just cross our fingers with the Wi-Fi.
Well, if the camera picks it up, I can hear every time Caitlin calls me, all I see is verdant green and hear birdsong. So that's Caitlin's new MO. I now say she lives like in the Garden of Eden and she calls me up. She's like a little Eve and I'm like, Caitlin, what do you need clothes for? And she says, because I'm a knitter. But otherwise, I imagine she's just out there eating fruit, frolicking.
Exactly. Although you're leaving out the fact that most of the time you sound bitter and you're like, go inside.
Well, that's
true. I don't want to hear your freaking birds.
That's true, because unlike you, I'm like Rapunzel in this little, my bedroom all day long, every day.
Poor baby. Yes, in this beautiful house with a house full of people and your mother baking and feeding you. You poor thing. Let's all get out our violins.
Thank you.
You.
I appreciate that. That's what I'm here for. So,
I know, seriously. So, what are you wearing, Jackie?
Oh, well, I just need to say something first, and then I'll tell you what I'm wearing. But I just need to say, hi, everybody. How are you? OMG, right? That's it. I just needed to say that. We're so glad you're here. I mean,
we're assuming you're here.
We have a lot in store for you and including what I'm wearing, you know.
Right. And I'm wearing.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, has it been a full month?
I think so. Podcasted? I think so. Exactly.
Yeah. So lots happened.
Yeah. So, we'll just dive right into the knit collage, how about that? The knit collage, knit along, and that excitement. So,
really?
you were. We got to participate, and we thank you to everyone. We had people who used that affiliate link.
Yes.
And thank you so much. And I have to say, we were able, because of our Patreons, also to give away a gift certificate for knit collage. And it just turned out that it happened to be a woman named Cindy. Hi, Cindy.
Hi, Sydney.
And she was a nurse. And it was just like, oh, it was so fabulous. So you guys, and she just said she screamed with delight and she was so happy about it. So that's all you guys.
So
thank you so much for that. Yes. And we'll keep that going. We have more on that later in the segment. But as far as knit collage, I think I'll stand up, and then you'll stand up, maybe?
Sure,
This is the Kaleidoscope pullover, and I mean, I did the straight version, and it does have short rows in the back. And before I talk about it, I want to talk about you and the poem and when we wrote it and everything, and when we made these, right? So, So, Caitlin moved to Tennessee, and
I did.
There you are. There's the evidence of that. Although some people wouldn't believe that. I know one of those people. But at any rate, and literally, she was on my porch saying goodbye to me when, and you know, that was not on my, I was on my porch. You were in your car. I wouldn't even talk to you. I'm so good at goodbyes, aren't I?
I know, you had no words. You had no words.
I didn't. What was I going to say? You know. But at any rate, the mail person delivered this yarn in that moment. Like, so Caitlin had left, and this was what I was given. And I didn't even want to knit this. I was just like, I was in a funk. I'm admitting it, whatever. And,
yeah.
And this was what we did in that transition, this garment. And it was so wonderful. And I'll talk more about the garment. But, you know, I'm a third grade teacher, and we have a poetry unit, and it was so fun. So I, for some assignment, this was the poem that came out, but I think it's fun for us. So, and this is called the Kaleidoscope sweater. And I happened to look up, whatever, I wanted to look up the etymology of kaleidoscope, and I ended up on Wikipedia, and here it is. My poem for my third graders and for Caitlin. It says Kaleidoscope for Caitlin. A kaleidoscope is an optical instrument with two or more reflecting surfaces tilted to each other. Rotation of the cell causes motion of the materials, resulting in an ever-changing view being presented. That's from Wikipedia. A friend is like a second surface, her eyes, her laugh, the necessary color that makes your whole life dance. Yay, looks like Caitlin froze a little bit during that, but
that's because I was frozen with love and admiration for you.
Yeah, and this, that's the thing I've been reflecting on. That was what I had to, like, come to terms with, though, is honestly that kaleidoscopic quality of friendship or of any relationships that you have, you know. I love that so much. And you could think of the knitting community as a kaleidoscope too.
Yeah.
Each one of us coming together and what we make amongst each other, it's beautiful. So this sweater is not like knitting, it's more like just playing and drawing or the...
You have to just sort of, unless you've knit with knit collage before, it is just an entirely new experience because every yarn is just so unique and feel like the tactile aspect of it is amazing. I'm going to show mine. So mine, I also did the kaleidoscope sweater, but just did different colorway than Jackie. And I also did, it's hard to see from this, but
we can see
I just
you.
Did the straight side. It did flare at the bottom. I still have a little bit of finishing to do, but I think that the thing that was amazing is I had no idea what it was going to be like to knit with the fabric yarns.
Yes.
And it was just, it was amazing. I mean, there was no part of this that was a hassle or, you know, sometimes people don't talk about not wanting to knit with big needles because it hurts their hands or whatever, but I didn't have any issues with that at all. And every piece, you know, you're just like, oh, how's it going to play with the next one? And you just have to really let go of any sort of grand scheme of what's going to happen. I mean, obviously you planned out a little bit more, I think, with your black and where
that was the only thing I planned.
Right. No, I know. But I mean, you don't even need to do that. I mean, it could just be so freeform, which is just amazing.
Right. I just need to show, like, I got the Blush Happy Wildflower Yarn Sampler Mini Kit.
Yeah.
And I was just, I'm covering you up for a second, Caitlin. I was so amazed by, you know, these yarns are so incredible. You know, there are ones that, I just want to show them all. They are so beautiful and subtle, and the way they come together. So I challenged myself. My mother, you know, there were things that I thought, this doesn't go. And my mother was like, no, use them all, you know, and I did. And and then the only designing piece was just, like Caitlin said, I decided to have black every, you know, so often.
Yeah, right.
Just to kind of create a frame around it. But I'm glad, I have to admit, I did buy these in addition, you know, for the, and this one. So I have a lot of this left. Because, I love this one too. Because I think I needed the brightness with you leaving. I needed more brightness. I just knew I did. Yeah. So, but the star of the show for me was definitely the wildflower yarn. What
Oh, for sure.
So.
Well, and you know what's really, I mean, I have a little bit of the wildflower with the little daisies and the, you know, I was so happy with the placement that they just, but you just have to go with it. Like, sometimes it's not going to be exactly where you want it. But I remember as I was knitting this, I was thinking about the Amy Small is the owner of Knit Collage, and she has put out some beautiful Instagram stories of when she goes to India and working with the women at the studio, and it just loved. I remember seeing a whole tray of these little flowers, and they have long threads on them. And as the women are, you know, spinning them, you know, they're tying them on and weaving them in. And it was just so nice to think about those women and that somebody has touched this yarn mm-hmm. in such a thoughtful way. I mean, it really is artisan yarn. There's so much time and effort put into it, and I love the idea that knowing that some. That there are women out there at Knit Collage who have just lovingly created all of these, and then we get to turn them into another level of work of art. It's just so amazing.
And the fact that it's a KAL, and that every Wednesday yes. night she has these, you know, live knit-ins, and that there's all of this video support and community support yeah. and newsletter support. I'm going to tell you guys something because I'm going to reveal. But just so you know, Caitlin, and you'll be so mad at me about this.
Oh, perfect.
Okay, what she's talking about are these little flowers, and they're wrapped on.
Hold it up so I can't see what you're showing.
I am holding it up. Hold it here.
Just hold it higher to the mirror. There we go. Okay.
Okay. Anyways, I wanted one right here, so I... Oh, I'm getting a notification. Great. Whoa! Sorry, everybody. Caitlin's going away for a second. Hi, Caitlin. There she is. Technical difficulties. Anyways, my big confession is as I unwound one, and I wove this one in right here. This was not random. This was me going, but
well,
I want one right there.
I thought of that, too. I know. Well, and the thing is, it's easy enough to do because you can just really just take it out. And yeah, no. Why would I hate you for that?
Because it's so fussy, like, and it's not like, oh, I just let it land there. I mean, the rest of them I did, but I sewed this one right here.
That's all right.
Okay, you we'll forgive me? Okay.
Yes, totally. I mean, you've got to work harder than that for me to be really. I was like, thank goodness I don't have to be upset with her about that.
Well, I'll come up with something better later. Yeah, so I have quite a bit.
I mean, I feel like I live in a perpetual state of jealousy of everything you do, so it's like, ugh.
These are the leftovers, you know, but that's because I didn't buy a kit. I literally, you know, just like was a piggy, yeah. And I plan to keep knitting with Knit Collage the because I have so much yarn left over. I thought yeah. I would do the Kaleidoscope pullover.
Yeah.
And
do
it goes... Go ahead.
Do you have the picture of the pillow?
Yes, and it goes till June 7th. I believe I do, Caitlin. Let me show it.
Well, and the other thing I want to say is that I think Amy is just so grateful for how many people have participated in this KAL. And she ran into all sorts of shipping issues with things coming from India, as you can imagine. And so she does think she's going to have like a second wave of the KAL. So if something that you really wanted is out of stock right now, just hold tight. She'll get more in. And there's so much community surrounding this that you'll get to participate in a level that will feel really good. And it's so worth, I mean, her yarns are just... It's worth the wait, even if you can't be in the first wave.
Yeah, I think it's like, it's a life, like, I'm a Knit Collage person for life now.
Oh, junkie, total junkie, yes.
I mean, so it was the first time, and now I'm a lifer.
Oh, and, I know, I mean, I think it's like, when you talk about, like, a stash, this is what people, like, what you want to stash, or these beautiful yarns that are so unique, and even if they just sit in a ball in a basket, it's just
right.
so gorgeous.
Right. So, right, yeah. I know. I mean, and it's funny because I have like 12 inches of one left, but I'm saving
yeah.
it.
Right. Well, because you can just weave it into something and, yeah.
Exactly.
Totally.
Exactly.
That's so funny. So, anyway, we are just been thrilled to be a part of the KAL We're thrilled that our viewers have taken part in it and have supported our affiliate link. So so thank you. And we like can't say enough about Amy and her business and her work ethic. And she just brings so much happiness and light to everybody and to everything that she does. So if you haven't started to follow her, please do. And her Instagram stories, I just love them. Like, she dances with her kids. Like, she does these crazy dances in the morning with her kids. And she's just so real. So we love you, Amy.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Well, I know. My next goal. Oh, I should show the yarn I have. My plan, I guess. This is what I would do my base in, creme brulee. And then I'll do this. And I know it's subtle.
Yeah.
But I just think
it's beautiful.
It'll be, yeah, like,
Yeah, I have subtle knit collage. Does that even exist?
This one, I think. But
I know.
Yeah. Although, God, I chose this one because I have a ton of this left. So it's almost good that she has kits so that you don't have to choose because.
Yeah. But that being said, I think, you know, I haven't updated my Ravelry yet. My plan is to update it for today. But I think the thing is, it is easy to be like, oh, I want that exact one.
Mm-hmm.
But that's sort of, you may order the kit and get exactly what you saw of another sample, but just know, like, it's so fun to just do your own. Like, I like, zoomed in on pictures and was like, okay, so how many stitches, you know, she doesn't really say, like, do two rows of the fabric yarn and then two rows of the spun cloud. Like, you really just have to go with what looks and feels right to you. So even if you order a kit, just know it's going to be your own.
Yeah, it's a playground.
So even, right, and totally. So, like, even if we, you know, you look at some, like, our Ravelry account, like, my base was the lavender, and then I had three different groupings of the wildflower yarn and things like that. Like, but you'll make it your own. And
I'm so glad you brought that up, because I think we both went into it with the superficial, like, I want that one. I want the one she made that's on, you know, and I'm not going to be happy unless I can recreate that.
Yeah.
No.
Totally.
No. And then, like, it doesn't let you do that. And that's what's so good about it.
Yeah. And even when you get, like, if you do something you don't love the play, it is not about focusing on this strike. It is overall, you know. And I did pull some scraps in of my own stash in too, which was kind of fun. Like, to have things that have been sitting there that you're just waiting for that perfect opportunity. It was like, well, there's no more perfect opportunity than knit collage to just throw something in from your stash. So.
Yeah. And my process, I generally, what I do is I put, like, four or five balls in front of me, like, and I think about that far ahead. Like, maybe I'd think about this in thirds or whatever.
Sure.
And it was fun having Sally around. I will say, just, like, some little things, like, that were meant to be color pops, you know, just to not over put them in or whatever.
Right.
But all of that was what made it so fun, was that thinking.
Totally.
Yeah, which we don't want to.
So I think that sorry.
I was just going to say, we don't want to give that to somebody else. We want to give that to ourselves.
No.
The play. What were you going to say?
Totally, the play. Well, I was just going to say that one tip that I would give is that I use the West Knits technique of weaving in my end pieces as I went. So I don't know if he has a video on it, but basically, instead of having a ton of loose ends to weave in, I just wrapped the tail of the one I was done with around my working yarn, and I would just, each stitch, I would wind it for maybe about this far on every row that I worked, and so I had, like, maybe three ends to weave in, which I thought
that's
was
amazing.
And you can't tell, it doesn't show at all the way, so I think that technique was awesome, and I would definitely use it for other things, especially if you hate weaving in ends.
Yeah,
won't all fall apart.
Will you give us a link that we can put in below?
Yeah, I'll look at, I just don't know if, I didn't watch a video, we took that class from him, and he talked about it.
And you remembered it?
I do. It's like crazy.
Wow. Well, maybe you can make a video of yourself doing it. I feel like I've seen him do it on an Instagram
story.
Maybe.
I'll look for it.
Okay. I would say the two techniques that I did with this is I just steamed this. I didn't wash. I mean, I'm sure someday I'll have to, but I just steam blocked it. I decided not to do any of the crochet. I just left this raw. It was fun. I'm showing you. I actually love the little pop of the fabric yarn pulling up here. I don't know. I just liked it that way. So I want it to show. And when I joined yarn, maybe in the back new yarn, and I would always kind of alternate that. Like maybe I'd go from the beginning of round marker, maybe I'd slip over and join three stitches over, and then the next round I'd join new yarn three stitches past the beginning. I just so that I didn't have one solid like line of joining new yarn.
Sure. Yeah.
Just so it wouldn't be so bulky for me.
Yeah. So one of the things about her flower yarn is that, you know, if you think about strips of fabric, you know, it's only so wide. So they're definitely knots quite often in the flower fabric yarn. And at first I was like, oh, there's a knot. You know, we all know, like, we come to a knot in our
right.
yarn cake or whatever. It's like, you know, tragedy. You know, seems like a tragedy. Right. But actually, I love, like, even when they pop out, like, you just leave them. They're totally solid. I believe she uses a Russian join. And so there were times that I think I just did that with the ends of the yarn instead of even weaving them in. I just did a Russian join, clipped it really, the little ends really close. So if it pops out, it's just, there's no way you would be able to pick that up in the whole scheme of this. And to me, it just adds more texture.
Right.
It's really easy to be free with it.
Yeah, and I didn't know what to do, so I just tied a knot and then I didn't feel like getting all precise about it or whatever.
No.
So that was my...
I have done a simple crochet border before, but I did do it here and I liked that, but I decided that on the sleeve edge, just, you know, did a regular, I think I just did a regular bind off. I don't even think I didn't do a stretchy one.
Mm-hmm.
And I did do, I don't know if you can, it's hard to tell what you can see. Can you see?
Yeah,
and
we
so
see.
I think for the bottom, it actually added too much weight. So I think I'm going to take it off and we'll see. But I absolutely love it. And I have to say, for Tennessee weather, it will probably be short-lived, you know, but in the mornings it's cool. And to have a short sleeve, at first I was going to do sleeves, I think.
Yeah, me too.
Because I feel like I've always had difficulty wearing short-sleeve sweaters because it just seems like you have to think about, like, if you're going to wear a sleeve underneath and all of that. But honestly, in Tennessee, it's so nice because you can have that warmth, but you can cool yourself off by having your arms free. So,
mm-hmm.
Win. Anyway.
Yeah, okay. And the only next thing, it's funny, my iPad here, I mean, we just have to deal. Oh, you had the sun come out.
I know. The sun is
like,
right,
oh, she needs sunglasses now. But we can pause and do a different segment, and you can just keep moving.
Yeah.
My iPad, for some odd reason, is showing grid lines right now, and it's distracting me.
Oh.
But anyways, it's fine.
I don't see that.
I would put my head right here to be symmetrical with yours. I now know that from the grid lines. But whatever. And
I like to see, you know, if anybody saw, like, looked at the little corner image, you know, we have quite the setup. My view is Jackie in a mirror with her iPad leaning. I can see half of my head, but
yeah.
I can see, you know, whatever. It's just funny. So whenever you're holding things up and showing them, I can't see anything. That's why I was like, could you hold it up to the mirror?
Oh, okay. I can do that.
Right, because, like, whatever you're showing, you know, bless you.
Excuse me.
All of your yarn bundles and things, I'm like, well, I've seen them before, so I can imagine. I'll watch, I'll replay it. So
That's
I'm just nodding along, but I can't see any of that.
That's cute. Yeah, that's funny. Yeah. Well, thank you for being such a good sport.
I'm trying.
I think we have a whole other segment to do about our current excitement, our current giveaway. But before we go there, it feels like ages ago, Clinton Hill Cashmere. Hooray for Clinton Hill Cashmere.
Woo! Rebecca.
Yes. We decided with our Patreon, we have a Patreon account, you guys, and we are really excited. We haven't done it yet, but Caitlin and I we're going to do it now. We're just announcing it here. With our Patreon folks, we want to have some Zooms, but we want to have it be small. So we're just going to contact you in clusters and use a Zoom room, the waiting room is what it's called, and then just come in and we can have some show and tell or some Q&A and people can meet each other. And it'll just be like 6 people at a time and like maybe 5 minutes. And it's no big deal, but it's just a way for you to, you know, like meet some, we would love to see who you are. You know, our favorite thing, you all know this, it's yours too, or some of yours, is when you go to a festival and you meet each other.
Right, in real life.
Yeah, in real life. But Zoom itself is very stressful. And especially when you have tons of people, so you need to make it small. So this is, we will be setting up a date, so look for those for our Patreon people. But thank you again. And this giveaway is sponsored by our Patreon people, and it's a $100 gift card to Clinton Hill Cashmere. And what people did to win it was they shouted out their local yarn shop. And that was somebody in the knitting community that they wanted to offer their, you know, hey, support this person. And about 2 weeks into it, I started to compile a list and I put them all on.
Ever ambitious that you are.
And I probably will finish that today and put that post out. But it was so incredible. I mean, stupid me, I thought I knew a lot of the yarn shops. Do you know what I mean? You think after a while, oh yeah, there's just so many out there. So many. Yeah. And just to think that of the job that these shops do to be like the anchor point for the knitters around them and to be able to see things in person and touch them and have somebody who's had experience with that yarn. It's just priceless. So we so appreciate everybody who shouted out and gave us ideas of places to visit and whatnot. And I will get that list up to date and repost it on Instagram over the weekend because it's just, honestly, it's really touching and beautiful to me that.
Well, and we know, we obviously have some nice ties with some people that we've met through Instagram who own little yarn shops around the country, Mermaid's Pearl and the Knot House and obviously Firefly. And we know firsthand how hard these women are working and how appreciative they are of your orders. And I love when that you see on Instagram the posts of somebody ordered this and you could just see what everybody's creative sort of projects they have in mind. And but it is, you know, it's obviously we're in scary times and these kind of businesses can really be affected. And it just feels good to do something small, even if it's just shouting out. But I want to applaud you, Jackie, for your tenacity of putting that list together. Cause I'm sure that it took a lot of time, but we really, and we hope, you know, I think the other part of the Patreon account is that we would love to eventually be able to travel to some of these places and highlight them and bring them more to your TV viewing or, you know, and so that's our goal. And so we do really appreciate those of you that are supporting our Patreon right now. And we're trying to give back, you know, in a way that shares it with others. And so if you want to join in, you know, you're welcome to. It's Cady Jax Knits on Patreon. But anyway, so we appreciate all of your support and we really do look forward to sort of reaching out through Zoom to do some more meeting with you. Mm-hmm. So should we talk about the winner?
Absolutely.
Okay. So we had, I think, 275 entries, which was a lot. And we did a random generator, and our winner is somebody who on YouTube, their YouTube handle is Through the Back Loop. And so I did a little sleuthing, and it turns out that Peggy Richards Patty is the woman behind Through the Back Loop, and she has her own YouTube channel and podcast called Through the Back Loop. So it was fun to sort of just look at her podcast. It wasn't one that I was familiar with, so I subscribed.
Yay!
And, just in the spirit of sharing the love. Would be great if some of our viewers checked her out and subscribed, and the whole subscription thing, it you don't have to have the notifications, but it just lets the people who are podcasting know that there are people out there who are interested. And anyway, so Peggy does her own podcast, super cute, and she gave a shout out to her local yarn store in San Diego called the Apricot Yarn Supply. So that was definitely new to us.
And I'm showing the website right now. Because, I hadn't seen it.
They have lovely yarns.
Yeah.
So Peggy, we will be messaging you, and then you can give us your information, and we'll be sending you a $100 gift certificate to Clinton Hill Cashmere. And if you haven't knit with it yet, you are in for a treat. And even if you've knit with it, you're in for another treat, because it's just divine yarn.
Yeah, and so if anybody else is in the San Diego area, hooray for Apricot Yarns and all of you there. I did recently, I couldn't resist the Jacqueline Beret. It was such a beautiful story.
That's from Clinton Hill Cashmere.
It's just made from her bespoke DK, and I got the navy. I don't even know. This is just an experiment, but I just thought it was so lovely. So check out her Instagram.
How many skeins does it take for the beret?
Just one skein for the beret. And
that's so nice to have a one skein project.
Yeah. So that's beautiful and a beautiful story. So thank you, Rebecca, she started a YouTube presence as well, where she talks about fashion forecasts and Clinton Hill Cashmere, and she's been doing all of those fabulous hats, like the Stay Home hat, and now Carpe Yarn Trish. She has one where she put in Cuomo Sexual, because she's just... Yeah, so, you know, those...
And we did our Cady Jax.
Yes, exactly. And then I, like, absolutely, like, sweater of a lifetime got to make the Winslow pullover, and I love it so much. And, of course, it's not pullover cashmere season, but as soon as it is, ooh, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. I know. Like, you have to wait. You probably sleep in it.
Yes, exactly. So I'm going to do an outfit change, Caitlin.
I think we both are, right?
Okay, so we'll just press pause and we'll do this again, okay?
It'll all be seamless.
Okay, all right, bye.
Okay, bye.
Oh my God, Caitlin, I love it. So we have a plane flying overhead here.
Oh,
look at your hat.
Isn't it cute?
Oh my God. Okay.
So we have another fun thing to talk about, but this pattern is by Sari, Norland. It's the BB Beret, that's Bisbis, and it was a total inspiration from Mara Lisa from Girl Meets Yarn, because everything she does is fabulous. She did hers in mohair, and I was like, knits a million berets. I'm like, I have to knit a beret. So...
Oh, Caitlin, it's adorable. So you can't see this, but I'm holding up the yarn. We are so excited to be able to share with you Julie Asselin's new yarn. It's Melange number one. It's 75% merino, 25% yak. It is divine.
Luscious.
Oh my God. I'm petting Caitlin. I mean, these are.
One of those things, like, it takes your breath away. It is so unbelievably amazing yarn. And I feel like it's better than cashmere. I don't know what it is. It has this structure to it that is so, it has like a density to it, but the softness and the definition of stitches and, yeah. Amazing. But, you are wearing, I mean, we'll talk about what you're wearing. I can't see what you're wearing, but I know what you're wearing.
Yeah. I think I need to flash the there's...
Yeah, show the colors. So the one I'm wearing is brownstone, just so...
And I'm assuming that this is the natural base that I have on, and the darker colors that I'm about to show you must be dyed on that natural base. So
right,
this
so
is,
there's more of a...
Oh,
yeah.
My God. Can you see what I... No, I'll put it
I
up in the mirror.
There we go.
Okay,
yeah.
Just kidding.
This
is cobalt. Oh, my God. So beautiful. This is bleh or something like that. Oh, I don't know. It's BLE. Here's Caitlin's brownstone. Then we have Lee's. Oh my God. So beautiful. Oh. Okay. Turquoise. And this one is, Joyful. So this is the darker palette. They are so beautiful. So beautiful. I have on Instagram stories a video of them. There's more to say.
You saved that, right?
I think
so.
So
it's still beautiful.
Okay. And then there's a natural base. I mean, another natural base that looks like this. Okay. And I believe, I'm sorry you can't see these, Caitlin, but you've
That's
seen
right.
the
I've
video.
Seen...
You've seen the video.
Yes, I've seen the video.
Oh, it's so good, Caitlin. It's so good. Okay. Anyways. And these are the lighter colors, then.
I think she likes it.
Yeah. Okay. So we have hydrangea. This is where I definitely need you here. A prairie.
Yes.
Bee. This is impressive on my part. Antique. Whoa.
I think antique is one of my favorite colors.
Brume or broom. I'm not sure which. Oh, this palette is so beautiful. And then the last one is Echo. So here's Echo. And
beautiful.
So what happened for us is Julie made this yarn for Montreal, for the Knit City in Montreal to debut there.
She was launching it there.
Yeah. And so and Elisa from Firefly Fibers carries Julie's yarn, and she said, would you like to share it on the podcast? And this is why we're so grateful to have a podcast, because to see it in, I don't know, more dimensions or to talk about it is just such a thrill. And it feels so magical. So I'll talk about what I'm wearing, but I want to stay focused on the yarn and
speaking
not...
Speaking of magical.
So this is the Astragal. And and so it's reverse stockinette, so the yak gorgeous loveliness is right up against my skin, and so I'm just basically, it's just too much.
It's too much for us too.
It's so good. All I can tell you.
It really is.
Yeah, it's so good. And look at this is the I think this is a great pattern for this yarn. So the naturals come in these cones too, and this cone is 780 yards, and I could have easily made this whole sweater out of one cone. And then there's a larger cone, which is 1535 yards. And I guess, evidently,
if you buy a cone, the cones only come in the, you know, undyed, but if you buy a cone, it's like you get a skein for free, and if you buy a giant cone, it's like you get three skeins for free.
Well, and I think one thing we want to mention about the cones is because the cones are wound so tightly, it definitely has a different hand. Like when you just touch it, it doesn't have the same
soft quality,
but it's completely the same yarn, and obviously it's very touchable. So just know that it will feel different than if it was just skeined, but it's the same yarn.
And here is the thrilling, over-the-top, amazing news for you viewers. I cannot believe this. Julie and Elisa are giving you
one lucky winner,
and we'll do this on Instagram, right? We haven't even talked about it. I want to do it on Instagram because I want as many people to see it as possible.
Well, and we want, you need to be, you need to follow Julie, follow Firefly.
Yeah, so that gives them, so go to Instagram. Again, I just, you know, you don't have to put anything on Instagram. You can just have an account so you can follow these things. And we'll have a post, and it'll be really obvious, and it'll say giveaway. And, you know.
Yeah, because, and we won't probably post that till later. I mean, today is Sunday, but it won't be.
I'll do it later. Yeah, I'll do it probably Monday so that, we get this up and everybody hears about it. But at any rate, and they're going, Elisa's going to send it from Firefly. You can get one small cone and two skeins of the yarn. And I know for a fact that she is making a love note. And Caitlin, I couldn't resist.
You have been very, very bad, girl.
I have been.
I can't see. I don't even know what. I mean, what is it?
Well, okay. So it leads to, I was going back and forth with you and Debbie, back and forth, and with Elisa. It was terrible on which one of these to get. The light.
The natural or the dark gray.
Yes. So I got both.
Oh, of course you did.
Right. So I'm going to make a white horse. I've always wanted the white horse in the natural, and this would be perfect for a white horse. Perfect for a love note. Both of them have shorter sleeves and whatnot, and are great for the yardage because the yarn it's yak, so it's a little more expensive. But the beret, what incredible.
Oh, the beret. So the beret took just like a skein and a little bit of the second skein.
So get three skeins, and then you can make one for you and one for a friend.
Yeah.
And it could be a friendship.
And they're actually really reasonably priced. I think the skeins are $18 a piece because it's less yardage. I mean, it's definitely, I think, a reasonable, accessory project or even sweater. I mean, the cones, to be able to get a sweater out of a single scone, single skein or a single cone, it's pretty reasonable given the quality of what it's made with. So
yes, I also think that the Andrea Mowry's throw over would be amazing in this, doing some color work. Yeah. My mom is going to do, you'll see it later, a soldatna. So
there are just so many possibilities with DK. I mean, of course, after knitting with this, I definitely want something that'll be against my skin, and of course, the ready is always top of mind.
Yes.
It would be such a beautiful drape to it. But I do think after seeing your Astragal, that might have to be in my future, and we might have to be absolutely twinning it because that gray is gorgeous.
It is. It's such a versatile color. So
It looks so incredible on you.
Thank you. I had some, I'm going to talk a little construction stuff for a minute.
Yeah.
It has a really strange increase that I'd never seen before, but once you learn it, you're fine. And I put videos to how to learn it in my project page. Just so that you all...
They were your own videos or somebody else's?
No, somebody else's videos. Oh, boy, okay. I'm just feeling a little sneezy. But
allergies.
But my gauge was to get
gauge, I needed to knit this on size 3 needles, which was strange, but that.
What did it call for?
It called for 5s.
Yeah, that's what I knit this out of.
Yeah, the fabric looked beautiful on a whole range of needle sizes while I was doing gauge swatches, but I just wanted this to fit. And the neckline is pretty wide, so I did it twice, and I ended up casting on a 1, and then doing a 2, and then moving to the 3. That was how I got it. And I can't recall anymore. I think it has short rows at the neck and then more short rows at the back. So the fit is really nice in the back. Like, I like how it doesn't ride up.
Yeah.
I love this bottom detail so much. I made mine, I think it's supposed to be, like, really cropped with like, wear with dresses sort of sweater, and I made mine longer.
Yeah.
And I say it every time, but I probably, my preferred sleeve length is maybe like right here, but I just wanted it to be different than the sweater length. So I think my sleeves are shorter than pattern, but my body's longer than pattern. And
yeah.
That's it. That's mostly all I have to say about it. Caitlin keeps trying to get me to do wider and wider necklines because you like them.
Well, look at it. I think it's perfect. It looks so beautiful against your collarbone.
Thanks.
I know you like to do things tight, and I always want them looser.
But please, by the way, like and subscribe here. We have twice as many views as we have subscribers. So either you're very dedicated and you're watching it more than once, or you're not subscribed yet. And it'd just be nice because, again, it gives us an opportunity to share things like the Julie Asselin yarn with you all. The more subscribers we have, then the more impetus people have to share their things with you all on this channel. So go ahead if you're watching.
We're doing it all out of, this is just fun for us. This isn't a business. We just want to promote other people and shout out other people and create communities.
So, absolutely.
Can I talk a little bit about the construction of this beret?
Absolutely. And
oh,
you,
by the way,
you just
Astragal.
Oh, I
you
was
didn't say who the designer of your
sorry.
Pattern is. And we'll have this all in our show notes. Jackie does a meticulous job with show notes.
It was in this Pom Pom magazine. I think it was last spring's. And here's the designer. And here's her longer sleeved, shorter version.
Yeah.
And her neckline is significantly, closer than even mine. So I don't know what the deal is, but so if you don't go down needle sizes and all of that, my understanding is people have really big necklines, so be aware of that issue or concern.
Yeah.
Caitlin, by the way, before you talk about your hat, I just need to say you rock a beret. You look amazing in it.
Thank you. Okay. I think it will not be my only beret, so I definitely want to do something with mohair and maybe cashmere. this is by Sari Norland, called the BB Beret, and the construction, most hats, I think, are knit, bottom up. This is knit top down, and you start off with the I cord of this, which I found to be so fun. And then it just has these beautiful, simple,
those are beautiful
increases. But it's so simple. It probably took a couple hours to knit. And I knitted according to pattern. And I didn't do a gauge swatch. So
with a hat, that's your gauge swatch.
Well, I think part of it, though, it is more like if you're knitting from bottom up, you already know if it really fits your, that is kind of like the same thing with a top down sweater. You can try it on. So that was great. I could try it on. I could decide how deep I wanted. You start doing decreases, I guess not really for the brand.
Can we talk about the nipple quick? Like,
Did you, is that the length that they wanted it? And is that so it doesn't look like a nipple or what?
It's not a nipple.
Sorry. I mean, it's not at that length.
This is my middle finger coming at you. No, it calls for six rows of the eye cords. You could certainly do less. I think you could go a little smaller. But then you get this little. You're supposed to get this little.
Cute. Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, so you can go less. I'm sure you could just do a couple if you didn't want anything at all, really.
Yeah.
But I think it adds to it. And then so you do the eye cord, and then you do these increases, and it's super simple. And then she has an eye cord.
Beautiful. That's beautiful.
You could do ribbing, but I really liked this, and I'll have to find the link for our show notes. I found a really great eye cord tutorial that I think is a little bit different than most eye cords. Now I can't even remember what made it different, but it was super simple and fast. So,
and you did this hat in like 2 days, right?
I did, and I actually ripped back too because there's a part in the pattern where you can make it a larger hat, which I think means just more slouch, and I didn't read the decrease section appropriately, so I had way too much slouch. I said I should send Jackie a picture, and I look like Fat Albert wearing a beret. Like, it was just like that cartoon character. Anyway, but yeah, you can knit it very quickly, and it's just an absolute joy in this yarn. So if you just want to dabble in something with this yarn, oh, it's so luscious. It's unbelievable. And so this is how much, I mean, I should have weighed it, but this is how much I have left of the second skein.
Sure.
So quite a bit.
Sure. And the pattern wasn't DK, but it worked just fine, right? Isn't that what you said?
So the pattern, there are two. The pattern includes two different weights, what she calls a fingering weight, but it's fingering with mohair, so it really is, I would say, a DK.
Okay.
And then she has a version that's sport.
Oh, okay.
So I think it's pretty versatile.
Oh, okay.
What you want to do with, but it's weird. The way she listed as fingering, but it's fingering with a strand of mohair.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So that's why I thought it was going to be fine in this DK, which it was. So, but it is pretty versatile.
So you could basically have a whole wardrobe of berets in all of the colors if you can't pick. If you can't pick one.
Very true. That's very true.
Yeah. And they are incredible. Yeah. I mean, it's been such a joy having them visit. I have to send that all back tomorrow, and it'll be hard to send them away.
But I know.
But I've kept
like
some.
Have them in your stash.
I know, it's like having a yarn shop in the house. It's so beautiful to see the whole color palette. What a joy.
Yeah. So just to recap, we'll have an Instagram post where we'll have you need to follow Firefly and follow Julie Asselin and follow us. And then we'll pick a winner probably in a couple weeks, right?
I think we'll do it this week.
Okay, this week. Okay.
Yeah.
And then we'll send out your yarn. So that's really exciting. But everything is live on the Firefly Fibers website. So check her out. Like, you don't have to wait for the giveaway.
Yeah, no. Grab yours.
Yeah.
And she's dying more. I mean, she's in the process of even making more as we speak. So if anything's out, there's more coming. And I also go ahead.
It will be something that she carries all the time.
That I don't know.
I mean, I think it was a launch at Knit City, but it's probably something she plans on carrying in her.
Yeah,
it's her yarn line.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. It's incredible, and I didn't check this out with Caitlin specifically, but the thing I was thinking about, what it was so fun. Hearing about the yarn and trying to come up with a pattern that would suit the yarn to show it off for you all.
Right.
That was such a pleasure, and to just go back and forth. Oh, Facebook is notifying me again. Like, I guess I never use Facebook, so I didn't know that notification was on my phone. But anyways.
I don't know if anybody can see your notifications.
They can. They can. Because I see them. But the point is, back to what I was saying. in the YouTube comments this week, this for this episode 31, what we would like the chance to do is play with you along the same lines. So if you have a yarn that you are aching to either purchase or it's in your stash, if you would share with us your yarn, and you of course would have to say it's DK and how many yards you have of it, and then we will draw one person and we'll have a segment on our next podcast where we get to talk to you all about, well, you know, let's pretend it was Cindy has this yarn, and we are going to share four patterns for Cindy to possibly knit with, you know. And I think that would just be fun to, you know, work with one of our, get to play, not work, play with one of our, because this is what we miss doing, is just chatting and going, oh, have you tried this? Should you, you know, that kind of thing.
Right.
So if you want to play with us.
Yeah, I love that.
Enter in the comments
do you
below.
Come out and play with
yeah. Me, just write down, oh, I have this yarn and I've always wanted to knit it. And what do you think? And, you know, and we'll be in touch and we'll just message and go back and forth. And maybe we can share out for, I don't know how it'll work. We're just making this up. But we'll share out what we thought. Maybe eventually you can share out what you did. No pressure. You could do nothing, too. But that seems like fun. All right, Caitlin. I'm getting really distracted here.
I'm not distracted. It's just that the sun...
No, it's your sweater.
Oh, you're distracted by my sweater? Okay, well, I was trying to get out of the sun because I was halfway in. I don't... Is the lighting okay?
I mean, sure. It's good, and I'm just going to move you to the middle of the screen. No, I better not. I'll keep you where you are.
So
okay.
I have...
you got to stand up. Oh,
so okay, good. This is my Sorrel by Donk Fiber.
Can you back up? Can you back up?
How's that?
Good, but you have shadow all over yourself. So you guys will have to look on Instagram, too. Oh, the fit is so glorious. It's so sexy.
I definitely did a little bit more of a cropped version with, you know, sleeves to my elbow. I definitely shortened.
Caitlin, you look like a goddess.
Really?
Oh, my God, yes. Such a beautiful neckline.
Yeah, I'm really happy. Like, the neckline is definitely on the smaller than I normally wear.
What?
Like,
that's so pretty.
Like, I want it wider.
What?
But this, so what I did was, and we've talked about it before, but I used Republic of Wool fingering in the Grand Budapest Redux. Just trying to get more in the sun.
No, you don't want to be, I mean, more out of the sun.
Okay. In the Grand Budapest Redux colorway, which just had this beautiful pinks and caramel color and yellow in it. And then instead of, the pattern calls for fading the yarn, like Jackie's version had several fades, but instead of fading the base yarn, I faded my mohair. So I had, I did use Manos del Uruguay's Cabrito mohair in the butternut color and then in the primrose color.
Pretty.
So I basically knit with the mohair stranded with my base yarn till about right under here, and then I started the fade. And her pattern's really great about giving you directions for how to do a fade, and it's basically 20 rows of alternating back and forth. So I just followed her fade directions but changed out the mohair. So that's the difference that I – but I thought came out pretty amazing.
What size did you knit? It fits you so beautifully.
Let's see, I think I have it on my Ravelry page, but I believe it was, I think it was the 40-inch bust line, I believe is what I did.
Can you move into the shade at all? You have, like, giant sun.
I'm going to try.
Oh, so pretty. So pretty. I'm just bossing her around. That's what I do.
She normally does it. Okay. Is that better?
Sure. Yes. Because we want to see you. There you go.
Anyway, so yeah, it just faded into it, and I absolutely love it. It just worked. So I'm really happy with it. Not sure how much I'll be able to wear it in Tennessee at the moment, but it's a good morning sweater. In the morning sweater.
It is. Oh, sorry about the dog. It was like one of the most fun projects. In years.
I liked the, for me, it was enjoyable to just fade with the mohair. I think it would be, it's a really versatile pattern, and you could literally do no fading whatsoever, and it's still amazing. These dip stitches are very easy to do. So I think it has a lot of impact, but it's not a difficult sweater pattern. And I know that she's coming out with a fingering, like a summer weight version. I think she's doing getting test knitters right now, mm-hmm. So... it's a fun pattern.
Yeah, and our friend Melissa, who's Well Knits on Instagram, she did one, for instance, that was just DK, right?
Yeah.
And it was just a neutral color and cropped, yeah, and absolutely adorable. The variations, it reminds, yeah, me of the Kaleidoscope, simply because it's right behind me.
Oh,
it's
sure.
been one of the most, it's been one of those phenomenons on Instagram, which it's been for so sure. delightful to see everybody's interpretation.
Yeah, no, it's a great pattern. So I'm really excited about that it's done.
Hooray! Yeah. Nice work. So
yeah,
and you have, we both have whips.
Shawl
whips.
Wait, can we do? Can I just show something that's not a whip, but?
Oh yeah, okay. Speaking of playful, it's a good segue.
So happy mail day. I just want to I'm trying to find a pattern just to show my inspiration. I'm looking in the pom-pom, like the newest version of okay. pom-pom, which people haven't gotten this.
Oh, I know. That's such a good issue.
Amazing. Okay.
That's in my near future.
So I fell in love with this pattern by Kindred Thread.
Will you show us?
Yeah, I'm just trying to find the good picture. So there's one version.
That's good.
That's a good version.
We can see that.
The base is, she uses Lang alpaca, but you could use a mohair base. And then she has these little bright pops of color. And I followed Kindred Red for a while because I just love her color palette. And so I ordered for myself and for Jackie. I haven't sent her hers yet. She's selling the kits now, so you can buy all of her, all of the yarn kitted up. But you can also buy the minis. That she used in the sweater, and she did these amazing little bags. You can see on her Instagram story, she was spray painting these in her driveway. And so anyway, she does the minis, and what she says is that basically, the way you get the little pieces for this is you just cut the minis right to the point where it starts to do a color change. And if you look at her Instagram, she's got some great shots of just a bag full of little tiny scraps. But that they basically, these three minis will do all that you need for that sweater. So I just thought that was super fun. So again, it's Kindred Red. And she, you should follow her because she's got some really beautiful yarn.
So cool.
That was one of my happy mail deliveries, and you'll get one too. So
yay.
Anyway, so then should we segue to
your other happy mail delivery?
So it has been a long time long time coming. So I'm knitting the Lune shawl. Did you grab yours to show? So Jackie's already knit one. Our friend Debbie just finished, so of course I cannot be left out.
Oh right.
My God, it's so fabulous.
Oh, you can see it. There
yes,
it is.
I can see it.
Oh, we love this shawl.
So this shawl.
Hi, Debbie. Hi, Susie.
Hi, Debbie. for a long time.
Yeah.
And once Jackie knit it, of course, I was. Oh,
so good. Speaking of magical yarn.
Yeah, seriously. So this pattern is by, now I'm blanking.
Moonstruck Knits.
Yeah. Moonstruck Knits, and I'm not sure how you pronounce this pattern. Lunae. So we call it the Lune or the Lunea shawl. And she knits it. So we've all knitting it to the exact pattern.
Yeah.
With the yarn selection.
Because when it's this good, why change it?
Right. Totally. So,
I mean, it is funny. There are patterns where it's very important to change, and this was not one of them for me.
Well, right. But I think that I will say this yarn is not very accessible. Mm. So when you look on Ravelry and click on, you know, where you can find this yarn, I could find it in 2 stores. In the entire world. So, and you know, there's this thing going on right now where everything doesn't ship very easily. And,
I gotta interrupt you. This is just a complete interruption, but I'm just, Debbie sent you some of her yarn, so you have a little bit of Debbie's yarn in your shawl, right?
Well, she hasn't sent it yet.
Okay. And then my friend Amy, she has a little bit of this yarn in her shawl. So it's, for us, a complete friendship shawl.
Yeah, totally. And it does take a village to make the shawl because you can't get the yarn.
Yes.
So it has two of the yarns are from Snaildon.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know if that's how you pronounce it. And it's in this this color and a white whatever. I mean, and then there's a blue that is from
Hilsvog.
So I will just say, check the Ravelry page. So this is the Hilsvog.
Mm-hmm.
It's from Norway. Anyway, I feel like the shawl is epic. So I ordered this blue from one yarn store, I think in Canada. And I've just moved to Knoxville. I'm actually in temporary housing. I'm living in my sister-in-law's house. That was not part of the plan. And I had this yarn shipped to my sister-in-law's house, only to realize that I had one number off on the address. So I've already been waiting weeks for this
ball
of yarn.
When I ordered the yarn, it came right away. I gave them the correct address.
But this is part of the epic story. I'm saying what it took just for me to get this yarn.
But you're trying to encourage people.
Oh, it's part of a story. Generally speaking, you can get the yarn without a problem. Just that I wrote the wrong address, and it said it was delivered, and I've been waiting for this yarn because I want to start this project, and it gets delivered to the neighbor's house in the cul-de-sac. Of course, she's an elderly woman who apparently doesn't pick up her mail, but she picked up her mail, and it was my package, and I didn't know how I was going to get it, so I left her a note, and she finally called. And long story short, I finally got it back, and then I finally got the other yarn from the other store, so I have passed on.
Look at you!
I know. So it's very exciting. It's a baby shawl, so this is the top. One top section.
Yeah.
So it was exciting, and it slip stitches. You know, and then there's a little bit of a textured pattern that Jackie was like, "You're gonna hate this." I think you can check back on maybe episode 5 where she's like, "You would hate knitting this." But actually, I find it really cathartic, especially in this time period, to just have to stop, slow down, and only pay attention to your stitches. I mean, it's a good meditation, that's for sure. So
excellent. Well, and this is the perfect time in your life. You have more time.
I know. Yeah. No, it's great. And it just feels beautiful. And look, I'm knitting with blue.
I know. Blue for the win. And Melissa from Espace Tricot, she knit a blue sweater.
It's a beautiful blue.
Whoa. That's exciting. And I remember, that just reminds me of my art trip to Wool and Honey, because this is what I was knitting that time.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
No, you were wearing it.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, you wore it to Rhinebeck.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Anyways, I got to take it off now. Oh, it's so good. I love this shawl. That's like one of my favorite shawls.
I know. I'm so excited to have that.
Okay. And here's my whip, which you saw last time. Which is the satellite shawl. And maybe by the end of this podcast, it'll be done. Because we have a Sally and Lily segment. I'm going to just put it on so you can see, like...
It looks so
amazing. I mean, it's still on the needles, but, like...
Wait, will you stand up?
Oh, I'm wearing it backwards. Sure. Not that it matters.
Oh, oh my God.
Right? So it has like brioche, garter, and then these short row sections. And it, can you tell the drape? Like, you can't tell how it touched, but it is, I would say it's like a long-haired, I hate cats. Sorry, everybody. I'm allergic. But it feels like a long-haired cat. Like, just so,
nice.
Oh, my God. So, the only thing I need to say about it is I think when we podcasted last, I was about here, and I had to rip back pretty much all of this because I did these short row sections wrong, but that's okay. I figured it out. And so there it is. And this is, yeah, it's so good.
So talk about the yarn. I don't think you said
it's La Bien Aimee. It's Helix, which is a lace weight, and you hold it double.
And that's one of their newer yarn bases.
Yep. And then their Kumo. And I'm actually done with these two colors.
Oh, we should do an exchange. Oh my God, that looks so amazing.
Yeah, no. Andrew Mowry has a new sweater out with takes three.
Yeah.
Like bands of. Oh, what are we calling
this? Oh, yeah, it would be amazing. Sari? Like, it would be amazing in those.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. So, anyways, you have enough to make that sweater. I think it's called like 80s or something. I can't remember.
It's called 70s vintage.
Yeah.
Vintage sweater.
Yeah, and I want you to know, Caitlin. Oh, look at that. I love
it. What do you want me to know?
I could have, like, stayed up all night. I literally have, I don't know. I mean, they're kind of long, but I have to get the pink section over to here and then do an I-cord bind-off. But I exercised self-control and said, who cares? I don't have to have this done.
Oh, see, I didn't realize that's what you were going for.
It's a whip.
In that case, our viewers are grateful that you took that you went for, I want to be healthy and have a good night's sleep versus look at my extra FO.
Yeah, because really, you can't tell it's not done right now anyways.
And nobody cares.
These are the most magical colors. I love them so much. And
I need that. Oh, so you got the kit from Espace Tricot.
Yes. And another one of the knits that will be something I have to knit one day is the LYS cardigan. I don't care. Like, I literally want it in the yellow brick road, and I just need to knit that too.
Well, it's such a good color for you.
Yeah, so.
Okay, yeah, so I think I have to be part of this club because our friend Debbie knit this shawl too. So what's a girl to do? It can't be left.
Exactly. No, this will be worn constantly. I mean, it is.
I was not secretly. I was outwardly hoping that you were knitting that and you were going to give it to me because you haven't even mentioned.
Oh yeah.
Epic birthday.
Well, that's your job.
No, you're supposed to like.
Oh, you guys! It's Caitlin's birthday.
Yeah, so I celebrated my 50th birthday during quarantine. That was super. during COVID. But yeah, so I was hoping that you were knitting that for me as a birthday gift.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Sorry.
No.
Not knitting it for you.
I mean, all right.
It's good, though. That's a good idea. No, I just told James what to get you for your birthday. But we'll talk about that our next podcast. We have such good stuff to talk
about. Something good coming, our viewers.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. So we could just sit here for like.
Touching yourself?
No, not with this on. We could just have a quiet moment of just everybody take in that this shawl is so good. Knit it with a friend though, and so you could. Your friend, I'm sorry, everybody who sells yarn, but your friend could literally buy the kit, and then you could buy two skeins of Helix yourself, and then you'd get two shawls. Like, because.
So that's what you're gonna do with me as your friend?
No, I'm not. Totally not giving you the but I'm just saying that our viewers could.
There you have it, everybody. You have just witnessed.
I gave you my last Sari.
Other people could have good friends.
By the way, people, if you're keeping score, do you remember the velvet? The, what is it called? Pink velvet? Where is pink that velvet. Sari right now? Where is it, Caitlin?
It's It's in a bin. Oh. You need to understand. I have just moved. Everything
I No, I don't care. I'm just saying. It's not like you're not without Sari. Yeah.
Let's just pause for a minute. Jackie gave me an extra skein of her pink Sari, so she is a giver.
Exactly. But I want to... I just want...
Time stamp on this so we can go
41 minutes in. Okay.
41 minutes in. No, of the second video.
Oh, sure. Okay, I can't stop. But
okay, put it down. You're distracting all of us.
Okay. So this is what my family decided, and I do think it's perfect. They said that I'm basically a cat, and then I'm just aloof, and all I do is just follow the sun around the house and knit. That is what I do.
I've never seen a knitting cat, though.
I know. And it's so cute because Lily and I are exactly the same. So we're like two pet cats in the house because there's only certain spots that have the sun. So we have to, like, share.
And as being part of a pet household pet, all of your needs are taken care of.
I do the laundry.
99% of your needs are taken care of. Am I right?
Yeah, they're pretty amazing.
98, because you're petting yourself as opposed to having somebody else pet you.
Yeah.
Right?
So. Yeah, it's pretty, yes, okay. It's nice. So, I forgot what I was going to say, other than just that Lily knits in bed all day, too, on the weekend.
I do the same thing. I mean, I've gotten a lot of knitting done because I am not currently working, and James is home working, and I'm out on our deck most days knitting. He comes out of here, he's like, you have not moved. This is what you do all day. I'm like... this is what I will be doing all day.
I love it so much. Yeah. So good. I'm here to support you. If James needs permission slip, I will write it for you.
I think he's going to need a lot more than a permission slip.
I have some future knitting.
Okay.
Besides the kaleidoscope, this gives me such pleasure.
You don't seem to be lacking in the pleasure.
Okay, so this is my morning sweater, and this is what I'm doing next.
And you've named it this.
I have. So, morning as in M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, morning. So,
you don't seem to be in any type of morning.
I was. And I still am. No, I have funks. I get in these funks, and I'm just in the worst mood. So anyways, but here you guys, let's see. Caitlin can't see it, but can you see that this is tweed silk mohair? Incredible. There it is, Caitlin, but you can't see it at all. You'll have to watch it back. So this is Shibui. This is tweed silk cloud. What? I mean, okay. So you run it with, you know, another silk cloud. So this is... and you may need to run it with three. I don't know. But it's black.
It's the $1 million sweater.
I'm supporting Firefly Fibers.
Yes, you are so good.
I think I've shown this 1,000 times, but it's the Frida sweater. And it has these amazing puff sleeves and this amazing detail. And I'll just need a, you know, there it is. So it's glorious. And that's what I'm knitting next.
And why are you calling it the morning sweater?
Because you don't live here anymore.
Mm-hmm. So you're in mourning for me, our friendship.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
So you're going to wear that every time you think of me and are sad?
Well, I think it's kind of ironic because it's like a mourning sweater, and then, yes, I'll be touching myself. And I think it's super sexy, but yet it's a mourning sweater.
Rationalization to me.
Oh, but it's black, Caitlin.
Right, it's true.
Okay.
I know I'm going to be very jealous of this sweater.
Maybe not. Because it's a style risk. It has puff sleeves, but I love all the sleeves.
Yeah. I don't think there's any riskiness involved.
Okay, fine.
For you especially.
Okay. So here comes the next I never do this, but a viewer said we should, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to show something I'm thinking about doing.
Why don't you think you should do this?
Because then it creates pressure, and I feel bad anytime I don't actually...
That creates pressure for you. Nobody's... That's just you and your craziness.
Okay. So, I'm not going to worry about my craziness. I'm going to worry about, instead, promoting this designer, because that's worth doing. So, whether or not I make this, this designer...
Oh, yeah. Another one that...
This is called the Art Sweater. And... I didn't mean to print the color copies, so don't, hopefully my sister won't see this, but you notice how it has two different sleeves, and it has these incredible baubles. It's, yeah. It takes a lot, look at this, as far as drama goes, you guys. What?
Yeah, I love it.
I mean, it's...
I've been in love with that sweater for a long time.
Yeah, so this is where Caitlin gets mad at me. Look
yeah,
at that
Jackie
face.
Didn't remember. I
don't remember you, but it's,
I
believe
found
you.
The Lune.
Yeah, I believe her, but I don't remember.
But then she'll like send me something like, "Oh my god, look what I found! Is this not amazing?" I'm like, I'm pretty sure I sent that to you
yeah,
quite a while ago.
That's why I'm.
And
annoying.
Then of course she's gonna knit it in a you know in a heartbeat and leave me in the dust. That's why I have a problem.
It's a high, it calls for a lot of yarn. I had in my stash this Farmer's Daughter Fiber Willow.
Yeah.
And when I was at Rhinebeck, I got some mohair to go with it. So I have this in my stash, and this is what I'm thinking. Like, I think this would be really magical.
It would be amazing.
Yeah. So we'll see.
Yeah.
That's some dream knitting. Is that what that's called?
Dream knitting, yeah. I mean, lots of people talk about dream knitting. It doesn't mean it has to come to fruition. But
okay.
It might spark something for somebody else. You need to get out of your head that there's any pressure.
Yeah. No pressure.
No pressure.
Just name one dream knitting project for you. Well, you're in it right now, the shawl.
Well, that, but I was also, I mean, honestly... the other one that I really have in my brain that I would love to do is this other, it's also from Pom Pom.
Yeah.
But is this pattern.
Yeah.
And this kind of lavendery gray.
Yeah.
And then, and,
That would be incredible on you. That's so your style.
Yeah, this is called the, the Abode. Anyway, let me look at the... So that's something I'm dreaming about.
Yeah, I have... we have some pretty magical earrings to share next podcast. And I want to knit a sweater just for these earrings.
Of course you do. Because that's so practical.
I mean, they so deserve their own sweater, though.
No, they do. Yes. Just like you deserve your own spotlight.
At least my own sunny window.
Right.
All right, you guys.
The amount of effort I had to go to today to podcast.
You look good. The lipstick looks good. The hair looks good. You wouldn't know there's a pandemic going on.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
True.
Yeah, exactly.
There is?
Yep.
No.
Yep.
Okay, so we're going to have another segment, right?
Yeah, so there'll be some time lapse because Lily's still sleeping, but but maybe my shawl will be done. Who knows?
Oh my gosh! Maybe I'll have a whole section done of my little.
I know. I could actually have breakfast right now.
Yeah. Well, we could also do Lily and Sally some other time.
That's true, too. You guys, by the way, we just want to say, what do we want to say? I mean, thank you for being here.
Yeah, thank you for putting up with our technology version. We got a lot of nice feedback that people liked us doing it with me on the phone versus Zoom. So
this is
because of you people.
Yeah.
So it's certainly not ideal terms of how we want to podcast, but it'll work for now.
People like that I have control over you and can dominate you.
Right, because you weren't doing that before.
Pick you up and bring you places. Hi, Caitlin.
I know, it's like Flat Stanley.
I know, it's so fun for me.
I think you need like a little stick that you know, maybe you should attach me to a selfie stick.
Exactly. Well, let's talk about that. Caitlin's got some equipment now, and she has to take selfies now, so she can't tease me anymore.
Wait, I'm gonna undo my setup so our viewers can see what I have going here. So I'm gonna flip this around. So I got myself a little tripod stand with one of those ring lights.
Yes. So that's, you're all that now.
Technology to make this happen.
Yeah. Well, so we are so grateful for all of you and that we're knitters.
Yes.
And, you know, it's crochet in May. If only I knew how to crochet, but it's goals. But I don't think it's, I just don't think it's going to happen right now. The most important thing I saw this whole time was a TED Talk. It was like a TED interview with Elizabeth Gilbert. And I can link that below. And I go back to it over and over again. And it's basically like, have a massive amount of compassion for yourself during this time. And I just keep remembering that. And she has this practice where, this daily practice of writing herself a letter. And it's like from love to her. Yeah. And what would love say? Like, what would love say in this moment? And love usually says things like, go take a bath, or have a cup of tea, or whatever. Love doesn't say, oh, you have to knit that shawl for the podcast, or you suck.
No, that's what Jackie said.
Right, exactly. So, at any rate, so we'll link that below, but if you haven't seen it, do watch it. It's so good. In terms of, like, all my plans to be self-actualized and use this to become a whole person, didn't happen.
Love says fuck that.
Yeah. But I'm still, you know, I just day by day observing all the things.
Yeah. Well, and I think that the knitting really has sustained us, and I'm sure it sustains the people who are watching this. So I think we are all very, very fortunate to have this outlet, because if I didn't, I don't know what I would do.
Yes.
There's only so much Netflix you can watch.
Right. And I haven't been able to watch anything. I don't have the attention span for it.
Yeah.
So yay for you if you've made it this far in our knitting podcast.
Right.
But
I just fast forward to the parts where I'm talking.
Exactly. But again, thank you for the people who support on Patreon, or just visit, just watch and subscribe. However it's comfortable for you, whatever you like, you know, do that. There's no expectations here. The only expectation is that you're nice.
Yes, be nice.
Please be nice.
Leave nice comments.
Yeah. But all in all, I just hope that this, you know, knitting is bringing you joy, and that we're so glad to share this time with you, and we look forward to meeting you. If you are Patreon people, look for, not immediately, we'll just kind of roll them out, but we'll be inviting you to join us to meet a meet and greet.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
No petting will happen, though, unfortunately.
No petting. Okay. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
We'll see you later.
All right.
Bye. Love you.
Hi,
Mom.
Hi, Jackie. Oh, Sunday.
I know. It's such a... This is not what we expected it to be, just the two of us, but here we are.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought it would be nice to have some Sally time anyway.
I know, because it's a strange and different time that we're living through, the coronavirus time and the stay at home with the six of us.
Yeah. And we joke a lot, like, as if you're just in your bliss caring for all of us.
Yeah.
But that is not exactly what is going on, is it?
Well, I love having... I mean, that's like the silver... You know, everybody talks about the silver linings. And the silver linings is, for me, this is the stay-at-home order doesn't really change my life that much as far as mm-hmm. my personal comings and goings, because I'm a stay-at-home person anyway. Mm-hmm. And I, you know, so that logistics of that has not changed. But what's different is nobody goes off to work, and so we're here all the time, and everybody's, you know, it's just a lot more busyness of family. And I am, like, in the deep bottom of my heart, so grateful that my stay at home is with my family. Mm-hmm. And I feel a great deal of love and appreciation for that. Mm-hmm. But still, I don't know. I was listening to the Grocery Girls the other day, their podcast. I can't mm-hmm. remember which one it was. And, mm-hmm. and I think it was Jody that was going on about, I can't seem to figure out what to put on my needles, or I go, you know, I just can't get myself focused on any one thing. Mm-hmm. And that resonated with me, because it's the ability to focus creative energy on a project and get all wrapped up in it and blissfully go down the creative tunnel of just sheer bliss. That's not with me right now.
Mm-hmm. Is that do you mean that flow state?
The state of just, mm-hmm. I watched a podcast with Elizabeth Gilchrist.
I talked about that earlier, and I said it, link it below. What was your takeaway? It'll be interesting.
Did you watch the new one that I mean, it was about how to seize the day.
No,
it's an interview.
A new one.
Yeah, it's just, you just have to go to Elizabeth Gilbert, and
you
I'm
mean
sure.
Current?
It's a current one. Yeah, it's a current one, because she's in her lovely, she lives in a church converted to a house somewhere. I'm not mm-hmm. quite sure. But anyway, so she talks about, it's an interview, and talking about her creative, you know, that she said, don't, you know, the first thing to do is to be very merciful and compassionate with yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, to recognize, you know, this isn't the time for the great novel or mm-hmm. the great this or the great that. Mm-hmm. So what she's finding is she's, you know, there's Elizabeth Gilbert, this fantastic author, and she's cleaning cupboards and organizing right. and all that kind of stuff that people do. But recognizing that, you know, what she was saying is to do something with your creative, that part of you that needs to be voiced in a different creative form. Like, you know, for me, quilting and knitting and those kinds of things are important. But what's happening to me is, because of all six of us being here, a lot of my time is just in the creative listening to my family, mm-hmm. Creative cooking, all that kind of stuff, mm-hmm. you know, that's been flowing. And so, though the quilts keep peeking out here and going like, well, this seems like a great time to be doing that, I even had this like crazy quilt idea that came in with all the 6x9 patches that I have for masks. And the leftovers when you're cutting out fabric that are like 6x8s that won't work, or, yeah. you know, that kind of thing, is to make this massive quilt installation just with those pieces mm-hmm. and see what happens, because it would be obvious to people that it came from this time.
If you don't know, Sally Jerney has Sally Jerney Quilts. She has a YouTube channel. But we're not expecting a new video anytime soon.
No,
but
you know, it's...
But
let's just say that this time has been just a real... As a little girl, I was raised by women that went through the Depression and mm-hmm. went through mm-hmm. World War II and even World War I. And their tales when I was growing up was all about how community came together and how people helped each other and all that, you know, really tough times. But it was just, that was the lore, that was the stories, those were the things that I heard. Mm-hmm. And so I'm recognizing that now, mm-hmm. like, there's no point in me whining my privilege of going like, I don't know when I'm going to be able to go to a grocery store and pick out just the right roast for the family. And I never realized how much part of cooking that is to me, is to be able to go to the place, hold the tomato in my hand mm-hmm. and go, this is the one I want, or mm-hmm. this is the, you know. And Jamie's been doing this fabulous job of bringing
my
it
sister.
All bringing it all in.
Right.
But they're having me not go to the grocery store. I'm grateful for that.
Mm-hmm.
But still, it's a difference.
Yeah.
So I'm not whining about it. I'm just saying that I'm recognizing that it's different.
Well, it's a different kind of creativity now, because it's not the creativity of, I want exactly these materials, mm-hmm. and I want this much time. It's more a creativity of what's at hand, improvisation.
And I have to say, what's been very funny is that I've discovered, you know, Jamie got all kinds of jarred tomato sauces,
mm-hmm.
you know, nice ones, you know, they're, but anyway, so what I've discovered is my family really likes, you know, and I always used to make them from scratch, they really like these jars of tomato sauce with the fancy basil pesto in jars, which I never knew existed. Mm-hmm. And so I just make these pastas, throw some lovely beef and pork and things like that in it, fresh vegetables, and they're all like, oh, this is so good. But it's because we're coming together at the table,
mm-hmm.
and with teenage boys and busy schedules,
mm-hmm.
but I would say 6 nights out of 7, we're all sitting at the same table having dinner together,
which is unheard of, and hopefully some of you are having experiences.
Yeah, and I don't mean to say that to people that are watching and going like, oh, listen to her, I'm all by myself, and I feel that, and I understand that, but I also have to go, it's funny how you look at other people and you go like, because Jamie has a friend who's here, and a woman who moved from California, and she's living by herself now. Never did she expect that in the 2 months or 3 months she's been here that she would be spending it in her lovely apartment overlooking the lake by herself. But it's also, you know, for people that are by themselves, and this is what Elizabeth Gilbert was saying. She said, don't feel, you know, I've got this. Don't feel bad for me.
Mm-hmm.
My creative soul, I'm going through and doing a lot of inner looking. I'm figuring out what is it, you know, now that I'm stopping enough to go like, what is it here that I have to, you know, what do I have to learn about myself in this?
I'm so glad you're saying that, because I was sort of thinking this whole time that I'm the only person in America who's not cleaning her drawers and closets,
mm-hmm.
right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I am cleaning out my psyche.
Right.
I mean, I'm not enjoying it very much.
No. Well, because this is different for everybody's going through it in a different way.
Right.
And so, you know, it's getting back to Jody, you know, and her,
mm-hmm.
you know, not being able to figure out what to knit, somebody that I've watched and has had no problem knitting
for years,
beautiful sweaters, you know, one after another. So that's gonna, you know, I guess the thing is that when I related it back to the women that taught me about how they got through it,
mm-hmm.
is I go like, there's a part of me that is just, I don't know, I'm so worried, so fearful, so concerned about what I can't do anything about in the future.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm worried about what we're gonna have. But I also hear that call of like, this is the pendulum swinging back to where all of us maybe need to make our voices more clear, that we are grateful for the government that we used to have, or we thought we did. You know, the FDR stuff is what I'm getting to.
Mm-hmm.
The, like, okay, we've got a really big problem. Let's all work together and let's make some
communal
leadership. Let's make some really good choices,
mm-hmm.
that, you know, the earth is breathing better than she has in a long time because of our slowdown.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that kind of stuff. That there's
mm-hmm.
going to be, the pendulum can swing and come back to a more humane. If all of us are so desperate, well, not all of us, but
mm-hmm.
many, many of us are going like, oh my God, I wasn't, you know, I certainly didn't have 6 months of savings in my account
mm-hmm.
to absorb for this.
Mm-hmm.
So we all need to look at that. But
it turns out that Elizabeth Gilbert, one of her favorite poets is Jack Gilchrist, I think his name is.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably getting that wrong. And my friend Trish from Carpe Yarn,
I woke up on Marco Polo and she read me the most beautiful poem. She was sure I knew all poems.
Yeah. Of course.
No, I didn't know that poem. It was so good. And maybe I'll go get it and read it to you all here because it's that good. Or I'll put it in the show notes. How about I just put it in the show notes? About...
Or you could put it in Instagram too. It's
beautiful. Well, just... It's just about the fact that... which I don't need to say what it's about, but the whole living experience, the dichotomy of the now and the future and the personal and the political, and how we're all just sitting right on that fulcrum all the time these days. Yeah, and it's a difficult place to be.
Yeah, because some days, I mean, like we had a day, it was a rainy day, and it was just like a family breakdown of, you know, everybody was having, I don't mean in a bad way, but... everybody was having a bad day all at one time, you know, the six of us. And that can be kind of hard when, you know, we've got space. But that's what happens with this, is you can feel really good in the morning and then in the afternoon, like, oh, the world's ending, and then swing around again.
So our bottom line, before we show you what Sally's been up to, is be compassionate towards yourself. This is the perfect opportunity to practice self-compassion.
Right.
Over and over and over again.
Yes.
And I'll just put the poem in the show notes. I'm going to go get it. What do you got in your hands, Mom?
Okay, so as far as quilts, I have a friend, I've decided to go back into making, I was going to make some chakra quilts or
something.
I'm
going to put it on its side just because that's the way our camera is.
Yeah. Roy G. Biff, you know, it's the rainbow, the chakras, just playing with these. What I did was I made like 8.5-inch blocks, and then I decided I didn't like that scale, so I cut them in fours. And so I have four panels to make. This is the completed one.
Yeah.
And I'm going to do an installation with the four of them together.
Ooh, that's fun.
But that is a fabric. Oh, I love that. That's a fabric I've got many years ago from Gay Feather Fabrics that is now closed in Madison. That was
beautiful.
One of my all-time favorite fabric stores.
Very nice.
Yeah, Virginia.
Virginia.
So we have panels. I have panels here that are...
Were these ones four squares or no?
Yes, that's what I was saying.
I'm sorry.
These were eventually... They were, to begin with...
It was...
They were
one square and you cut them four ways.
Yeah. Each color was an 8.5-inch block, and then I didn't like the scale, so I cut it in four because I liked what happened when they cut in four because they were more interesting.
And that's Sally's process.
Yeah. They're more interesting that way.
Yeah.
So they have a lot of fun pieces of fabric in here. And then this beautiful linen, I think that's a Pearl Soho. I have... You know, I got a bunch of linen about two summers ago. Anyway, it's
beautiful.
Just a beautiful... So they're going to be just hanging together.
Nice.
That's what I'm thinking. So that's
incredible.
That was about all I had in me for quilting, because I made masks, and I still have tons of 6x9-inch fabric in this little cart next to my sewing machine, and... So far, we've had enough masks for everybody in the house, and lots of people have sent them, you know, several different people have asked.
She's not selling them, she's just making them.
Just making them when people need them, and I'm seeing that that'll probably go on for some time, so I'm going to... But I do want to give a tip on mask making, because people ask me about this. Evidently, there's been an elastic shortage, and I've kind of seen it. I'm leery. Sometimes on Instagram they'll have like big spools, and whenever anything comes on Instagram that I have, you know, it's like just an advertisement. I don't follow those because I've heard there's scams out there. And if there's
that's
a shortage,
that's
observation.
Okay.
So anyway, my tip,
tip
was I had a couple of really nice flannel sheet sets that were worn out, you know, one of them had a hole in it. You know, they were the kind of things when you want to use after sheets get old and you use them as drop cloths and things like that. The fitted sheets tend to be kind of a nuisance, but the fitted sheets, if they're nice ones, have really good elastic in them. And you think about it, I mean, they've just been on a bed. It hasn't really stretched them that much. And so I've taken elastic out of bed sheets, which takes me back to the Depression era and the necessity of, so that I have this soft elastic that...
I wish I could report I've been, like, just virtuously combing my stash for yarn, but no, I've been obsessively buying yarn during
this
time.
Well, I have been, too, because it's like, you know, we've laughed, but it's like the... I couldn't wait for Sandy by the lakeside to have her bags. What was she getting ready for a show? And
was she going to be at Montreal too?
I think she was. I think something that she was making all kinds of bags for. And so if you follow her, she has this beautiful work ethic, beautiful aesthetics, and her studio, everything. You know, when you watch her making bags, it's not messy like the way I make things, you know, they tend to fabric all over. She has this, like, very beautiful assembly line making. But I know she works really hard when she's doing that. But anyway, so her bags, of course, are so popular that they come online, and if you're not there, you're going to miss them. Well, I got online, and I missed all the little ones, the little patchwork things that are the kind of things that are very cute, and I was going to get Lily one and stuff, but... You know, good for her. She sold all of them, you know, before, I think it was 3 minutes into the... So I'm very happy for her. But I managed to get one project bag.
You got my favorite one,
I didn't even know that. But anyway, so it's coming. So what we've been laughing about in our stay-at-home thing is, because there's six of us... The party's in the post. And so that's coming, and oh my goodness... Elisa at Firefly Fabric.
Firefly Fibers.
Fibers.
Yes. We've kept her partying.
We've kept her partying.
She's been on
She
said she hasn't seen me in 2 months. I'm like, well, we've been partying with you on my front porch.
You know, I just keep ordering yarn from her because...
Can I talk about this really
you
quick?
Can,
because I didn't show this yarn because you have...
I have it.
Yeah, so these are two different colors, too, of the Melange number one. So this is Vignette. So gorgeous.
Oh, they're so
gorgeous.
And
this one is Licorice. So it's this incredible. I love this color.
I do too. That's my favorite in the whole.
This.
Yeah, I could have ordered, you know, like when I was ordering from her, I'm going, I didn't realize that they were smaller, but, you know, because I'm going like,
look at
I could get many of these.
I could go down the rabbit hole just being obsessed.
I know.
So show the little drawing that Lily made and your other two yarns.
Yeah. I started to make... a soldatna, is that what you call it, Andrea Mowry?
No, this is Boylan Big...
Caitlin Hunter.
Caitlin Hunter. Boylan Big Works. It's okay.
Caitlin Hunter. I get them confused.
It's okay.
But anyway, Lily took the drawing from the pattern and recolored it. Because this is what I mean by Corona brain, I have to admit this. I ordered Arbor... in the colorway Heron.
Just because it was called
from
Heron?
From Firefly Fibers, yes.
I think they saw this one last time.
Yeah, I showed that one.
You were going to make a Rift Tee last time.
I was going to make a Rift Tee, then I was going to... You know, I had several things.
Yeah,
like,
all
I've
the
just
things.
Been,
oh,
like,
and there's a new Brooklyn Tweed
pattern.
I
mean,
that's adorable.
I keep buying the patterns. Yeah. You know, I am a great... I buy patterns. I'm
supporting
small business. Yes, so because I'm looking at that, you know, rabbit, and I go through there and go, oh my God, my arbor would be great with that, so buy it, you know, that kind of stuff. But anyway,
your first
so this is what I came up with, and I thought, you know, and I was showing this to Lily, and then, you know, I had a couple of colors, and Jackie goes, you know, because we were, you know, about how we, when that package came in?
Did you hear that we're... Abel, Julie, and Elisa are giving away a whole cone plus two skeins.
Oh, wow.
So we'll put that on Instagram later today, and it'll be up through... We'll
I
announce the winner on
colors.
Mother's Day.
This would be my vote.
Vignette and Licorice.
Oh, look how... Because the cone is the natural, isn't
it? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. That would be gorgeous together.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
back to scatterbrain.
Okay.
Anyway.
Yeah,
so I finally... So when I decided to do...
Oh, my God.
Yeah. When I decided to do the soldatna, Lily did this for me, which was very sweet, because I cast on knit to the first color change in the yoke. I mean, many of you have done this one. In heron, thinking that, oh, that's C1. You know, obviously I was thinking main color. Didn't look at the drawing at all. And then I realized that no, because what I wanted C1 to be is, you know, it's the one, I wanted heron to be the one that's the body. And then I'm gonna make longer sleeves. And so I wanted it to be, because that's the one I have the most of.
And this is Sally's first color work sweater. So I will try, I know some of you have asked for like tips on color work. So if Sally and I have little moments of tutorials, mm-hmm. we'll try to video ourselves in that.
Yeah, and can I also say?
Yeah, Molly's gone. She's
Molly posted in her stories a walk in her, where she is in Germany, mm-hmm. with her husband and her mother-in-law and her mm-hmm. two little girls walking through a German, you know, with lilacs and all that. So she's there safely.
Yeah.
But I wanted to get some of Molly's yarn before she left.
Yeah.
And this is a beautiful merino. It's a...
Molly from the Homespun House. Mm-hmm.
I mean, look at the speckles on this.
It is beautiful.
And it's a squishy, gorgeous, because it has cashmere in it.
Oh, yeah. It's a 20% cashmere.
Yeah. So that will be one that goes in the soldat. Not... That's the light color.
All right, and then Sally, you're going to show us one more shawl.
One more shawl.
And then we got to get going, because ever since I, Tracy from the Grocery Girls talked about knitting her knit collage, and she said she was making Rice Krispie treats.
Want Rice Krispie treats.
So I need, and it's been, I've been at this for a while now.
I'm hungry.
You can see I'm in my third outfit of the day, and I'm ready for my Rice Krispies.
Okay.
So you show us the pattern.
This I found just in casual.
Another shawl pattern.
This is another shawl pattern.
Okay.
And one of them is, I'm thinking about putting like three things on the needles, plus my knitting. And this I thought was the cutest thing. It's a, you can say who the person is, but it's called social distancing wrap.
Lucinda Iglesias.
And you have to look at it in detail because it's the mosaic knitting. I love that. And it has a diamond or a arrow shape in one side, and then the other end is just a rectangle. So you kind of, I don't exactly understand, but it's 6 feet long. So that's where the social distancing shawl is.
And you were able to
I had gotten these Salty Dog Dream State from a knot house.
Mm-hmm.
And I
have
my little basket here with, I've got shelter in storm clouds, and I think I have, you know, I have some other...
this is the quilter in Sally. She just collects these little bits of yarn.
Stay ready in Dream State, and I have, this is the, I can't remember exactly. I think that's Pussy Willow. That's
That is.
Pussy Willow, and so those will get wrapped up in there.
So when you come back... Maybe you'll have some knitting.
Mm-hmm.
But
I will. I'm going to try to get them on the needles, but that's the...
That's okay.
That's what I'm talking about, the corona brain.
Exactly.
But I did, you know, I have ripped back, and I'm ready to go. Because I think when I got my note from Alyssa, she said, I can't wait to see your knit. You know, and of course, she's like this prolific knitter, so she's thinking she'll give me a couple weeks and I should have the sweater done.
She's not thinking that.
Oh, she's not?
No, okay. It's all good.
Okay.
So when we podcast next time, we'll see you in a little while, but and Caitlin will be on here again in another outfit change saying goodbye.
Oh, right. Mm-hmm.
But in the meantime, do you have any final parting words for folks before we go make Rice Krispies?
Well, just stay safe, stay well, and try to
be compassionate.
Be compassionate to yourself and to everyone else.
I keep forgetting what Carla, our yoga teacher, says. There's three C's: compassion, creativity, and is it courage? I don't know.
I think it's courage. Yeah, and it's all those three things.
Yeah,
and try to, you know, if you haven't tried yoga, this is a great time to try it.
Absolutely.
It's wonderful. There's so much online right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Hi, Lynn. It's you again.
Jackie.
You're in your Tennessee t-shirt.
I am. It got too hot for my knits.
Yes.
Where's the linen when you need it?
So where are you and James going?
We're going on a boat ride.
Oh, okay. Kayla just joined the other half. That's fine. That sounds wonderful. Just protect your skin. Wear sunscreen.
I already just put on 50.
Okay, good. Before you go, I wanted to say that we still have the second sweater cal going. We decided for that to end in August, right?
I think that's what we said. Okay.
So I can either knit a linen ranunculus, because I have yarn for that, or a white horse. But I have till August to knit my second sweater.
Yes, you have plenty of time. No pressure.
No pressure. And then I just wanted to tell you too, Caitlin, that I made a... Let's see. I made a video for my sister that I'll plug in the show notes. It was the crochet cast on, the provisional crochet cast on, and tubular, the tubular cast on with the shibui links. So that's there. It is not like some profesh video that you would like, you know, it's not very Pink Knits. It's very Jackie boring video, but hey.
Did you have a good manicure for it though?
No, because it's COVID. No, man. I mean, I guess. Yeah. So,
I'm
no.
Sure, your nails look beautiful.
But it's there.
Yeah.
And,
yeah, perfect.
So, and then what's the next one? Somebody else wanted how to fix brioche. So maybe next podcast.
Oh, yeah.
I'll do that. That's.
I would love that.
I mean, you needed to tune back in just to hear that.
Definitely.
Yeah.
And actually, nobody's even tuning in because you're editing this whole thing. So they'll be like, what are they talking about?
Yeah. So what has transpired between your being here the last time and now is Lily and Sally have been on, and you will be like watching it with everybody else.
I know. I'm sorry I'm missing that part. Next time we'll coordinate our schedules a little bit better.
We're doing the best we can.
We are. So really, I'm the only one who's losing out on this right now.
Well,
so just know I'm there in spirit, or I was there in spirit. I've already seen it. Anyway, yeah, so it's all good.
Yeah, so I just thought you'd want to get on and say goodbye. And I just,
I
before
do,
you
want...
say goodbye, I want to complain about everybody doing lawn work. Stop doing lawn work right now. I'm podcasting.
I know, that's why I feel like every time I go outside here, last time when you and I podcasted, we did a little video for Knit Collage, a truck was in the background running its engine the entire time.
Yeah.
Today it's just birds. So.
Just, yeah, every time you call, it's birds. Okay.
Yeah, but you should be excited about the fact that the weather is such that people can do lawn work.
I should be. I'm a knitter. Like, what do I need good weather for? Just kidding.
You need to live in the Arctic.
Just kidding.
All right.
I appreciate a nice day. All right. Well, anyways. So,
totally.
Caitlin, we love you. And Caitlin, and thank you for tuning
right.
in.
Yeah, thank you so much. I can't wait for number 32.
Mm-hmm. All right. Bye, everybody.
Okay.
See you next
Bye.
Time.